Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be coding the left Riemann sum in Python. Let's briefly recall what Riemann sums are. Riemann sums are a numerical method that allows to approximate a definite integral. These are the simplest forms of numerical integration and are commonly taught in early calculus courses. The left Riemann sum will use the upper left part of a rectangle to approximate the area under the curve, hence the name. This schematic here should make that more clear. Alright, so let's get into coding the left rule in Python. I'm going to be coding this in PyCharm, which is a free, downloadable, integrated design environment. To begin, let's create a new file. Then, we need to import our relevant Python libraries. As we are going to be both approximating the definite integral and graphing our function, we will need two Python libraries. We need NumPy and matplotlib. Let's come to our interpreter here in the bottom right corner. As you can see, it says LRS, as that is what we created initially. Let's click this and hit Interpreter Settings. This is very important, as if you have the wrong interpreter selected, Python won't recognize the packages that we are about to download. You can change your interpreter up at the top here if the wrong one is selected. Once you have the right one selected, let's click this small plus sign down here. We will then search for NumPy, select it, and click Install Package. Once that is complete, we will repeat the same thing for matplotlib. Now that all of our relevant Python packages are installed, let's close this window. Now that the packages are installed to our Python virtual environment, we need to import them. So let's type import numpy as np and import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Next, we need to create two function definitions. One for a function that we are approximating the integral for, and another optional function for its derivative if you wish to find the maximum error. Both these functions will take in some value, say x, and will return the result of our function. Let's list out our function parameters that we need. We're going to initiate an iteration variable for later. Then we have our lower integration bound a, our upper integration bound b, and our number of equally spaced subintervals, n. Then, let's start our x variable at our low integration bound a, and make this formula to find our step size, dx. So that is just going to be the distance over which we are integrating, divided by our number of steps. Then, lastly, we'll initiate a variable called area sum to keep track of our rectangle's area every time we count a new one. In order to plot our function using matplotlib, we need to create values for it to plot. To do this, I'm going to make a variable x, which uses NumPy's lin space method. This creates a simple 1D matrix of n plus 1 sections from A to B. We use n plus 1 here, as our number of inputs needed is always one more than our number of subsections. Then, to find the outputs of all of our equally spaced intervals, all we need to do is call our function from earlier with the 1D matrix as our input variable. We are now going to create a left Riemann sum loop. I'm going to create it in two ways. Firstly, we are going to use a while loop. We can say that while I is strictly less than our number of subintervals, our area is our step size times the function evaluated at the left side of our rectangle. Then we add this value to our area sum term, increasing our x positioning and our iteration counter, then let the loop continue. Secondly, we could use NumPy's sum method to just take our 1D Y matrix with all but our last point times our step size, Both these methods shown will give the same result. Let's just go ahead and print the results of both these methods to validate that they are indeed the same. And there we go. Next, let's add in a way of calculating the maximum error of our left Riemann sum. This section will be finding the maximum first derivative of our function that will then be plugged into the following formula. Our 1D matrix of x prime here is just saying that within the bounds a to b, create an arbitrary amount of inputs. I just put n times 100 here, but you can really put anything. The more points created here, the more accurate your answer will be, with the trade-off of a slightly longer program runtime. This is because we are basically just checking more inputs to see what their outputs are, and that just gives us a better idea of the maximum actual first derivative within our bounds a to b. Printing the maximum error, you can see that with more subintervals, our maximum possible error decreases as we expect. At this point, we are essentially done with finding the left Riemann sum. I'm just going to add a small fprint statement that returns our value in the maximum possible error. Lastly, I'm just going to add a couple of lines of matplotlib code to print out a bar graph with markers to demonstrate our left Riemann sum graphically. Recall that the square bracket is saying call all values but the last one, as the left Riemann sum does not use our final x value, or our b value, as an input. As you can see, increasing our number of subintervals allows us to approach our analytical solution of 305.3. There we go. We have now just coded a very simple left Riemann sum that can find the left Riemann sum, the left Riemann sum maximum error, and provide a simple graph. This is not the most intricate or concise Riemann sum code. I wanted to ensure that it was simple and easy to read above all else. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how you can code the left Riemann sum within Python. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.